I'm hunted by the law.
Sheriff, Wake's running. I'm giving chase.
Are you seriously telling me that Ryder just took out my deputies?
A thriller I supposedly wrote is coming true. The genre of the story seems to be shifting. It's turning into a horror story. I was told that Alice had been kidnapped, but that was a lie.
We don't have his wife. We don't know where she is.
Her purported kidnapper was eaten up by the dark presence before it attacked me.
Alan. Shh, baby. It was just a nightmare.
Alice. Hartman, I fell.
I had to give you a sedative. Don't fight it. You went through another rough period.
What?
Right now, it's very important that you stay calm. We don't want you to have another episode. You're a patient at my clinic. Have been for a while now. The shock of your wife's death triggered a mental illness.
No, you're lying.
You're suffering from various symptoms of undifferentiated schizophrenia.
Bastard.
It's okay, Alan. Just let go.
I felt groggy. Whatever Hartman had bumped in me was making me numb. I felt like this was happening to someone else. Someone I was watching on television. I couldn't think. Couldn't focus. The door was locked. I was a prisoner here.
Good evening, Alan. Are we feeling better now? Feeling calm?
Yeah. I see you brought your pet gorilla with you. So sure, I'm calm. I get the message, loud and clear.
Quite right. That's the spirit? You're being very brave, Alan. I understand you're confused. I would be more concerned if you weren't suspicious of me. I don't blame you for it.
Big of you.
Now, why don't you come with me? We'll reacquaint you with my clinic and go over everything you might have forgotten. Little walk and some fresh air? Yes, it will do you good. This corridor is for patients. Most of them aren't here right now. Jack took them out for a fishing trip. Except for the ones who are particularly vulnerable, of course. I encourage creativity as a part of the recovery process here at Cauldron Lake Lodge. I specialize in treating artists.
I bet you do.
Splendid, Alan. I honestly believe we can get this thing under control if we work together. This way, Alan. Now, Alan, from past experience with you, I know I need to get right into the heart of the matter as quickly as I can after an episode. So I'm just going to say this. Alice is dead.
No.
You're in a very vulnerable state until you understand and accept this. Alice drowned, and you couldn't face that. You're suffering from hallucinations, paranoid delusions, unusual thinking, an obsession about light and darkness, a feeling that everything revolves around you, your thoughts and dreams. Your mind has constructed an elaborate fantasy scenario in which your writings are affecting reality. She has been kidnapped, and supernatural forces of darkness are trying to stop you. We go this way, Alan.
I wasn't ready for another shot, so I went along with it. He had to be lying. But under the influence of the drug he had given me, I had to fight not to believe his words.
It's all in your head. You've been making it up. Apart from the tragic accident with your wife, no one has been killed. Your delusions are just a manifestation of your subconscious mind trying to protect you from the too painful truth. Unless we fight the fantasy, it will return. I know the instinct is to resist me, but think about it. Doesn't this make far more sense than the insane supernatural conspiracy you have concocted in your mind? You're a skeptic by nature, Alan. We both know this. Everything can be explained logically. I never get tired of this view. Very inspiring, isn't it?
Cauldron Lake spread below us. I could see Mira Peak on the other side of the lake. I thought I could make out the spot where Diver's Isle had been when I arrived with Alice. Now there was nothing but waves.
It seems there's a storm coming. Funny, I don't recall there being a mention of that in the weather forecast. Well, no matter. This way. Follow me. Alan, what I'm telling you is good news. Right now, we're in control. Every time you have a relapse, it gets more and more difficult to resurface from the dark depths of your imagination. Not surprising, considering your profession. Imagination is what you work with. After all your nightmares, this should come as an immense relief to you. If it doesn't, why is that? Because I'm lying? Or because you don't want to admit that you're not well. It's very natural for you to think of me as your enemy. It's part of the illness.
I let him talk.
After all,
Hartman obviously loved his own voice. His words echoed madly
yourself.
Inside my head.
But I can't.
I dug my nails into
myself.
The palms of my hands to stay
you
focused.
You need to work with me. Once you accept that, we can begin the journey towards your recovery. Come along. Let's go inside. Here's the entrance to the office wing. That's for staff only. You were impressed by my trophies when you first arrived here. I do love to hunt. The great outdoors, man versus nature. It's wonderful stuff.
Pretty damn wonderful, yeah.
Scary, scary, scary.
Emerson.
I'm a real bad dream, mister. You should be afraid of me. Don't want to run into me in the night, that's for sure.
Please, Emerson. Mr. Wake is confused enough as it is.
Yeah, you'd like me to go away so you won't be scared. But you can't just decide what kind of dream you have or when you have it.
Emerson.
Okay. Sorry.
Boo.
That's Emerson. We're actually making some progress with him, I'm happy to say. He works on video
elbow
games.
Strike. Ooh,
it's
yeah.
Trash, of course, but it does involve some small creative effort, which makes him receptive to my therapeutic methods.
No kidding.
Come, Alan. This way. Now, you might have noticed the typewriter in your room. You've been writing as a part of the therapy. As soon as you feel up to it, you should continue.
My rheumatism's killing me. There's a storm coming. Oh, what a storm.
I hope it wipes this place off the face of the earth.
And these two are the Anderson brothers, Odin and Tor. They had a, how should I put this, a heavy metal band in the 70s and 80s called Old Gods of Asgard. They even adopted new first names to complete the image of Viking gods. After the band broke up, they lived on a farm nearby. They are, well, in advanced stages of dementia. They're well cared for, TLC and all that. There's nothing more that can be done. I'm afraid that the rock and roll lifestyle has left its mark. Oh, that won't do. I'm so sorry to cut this short for now, Alan. The power has been acting up. I'd better go check on it. We'll continue this soon. Meanwhile, when you feel up to it, return to your room and try to write. It really is for the best. Don't you think?
like to bash his head in with a hammer.
Oh, he'd love to fish out our secrets, but he has no clue. He's not crazy enough. Not crazy like us, Sonny.
Yeah!
Being crazy's a requirement, Sonny. Who else could understand the world when it's like this? It takes crazy to know crazy.
That's the sanest thing I've heard in a while.
Say, you're all right, Tom. Hey, we like him, don't we, bro? He's got to go to the farm.
The Anderson farm. Valhalla!
We wrote it all down, lest we'd forget. A crash course. All you need to know to get your head right. You need to find the message.
Here, Sonny, here's something for you. Gave me a rash, but I kept it safe from these bastards.
My head was clearing up, or according to Hartman, I was sinking back into the fantasy. I was convinced he was lying to me about everything. Crazy or not, the Andersons made more sense.
Yeah, good thing he's not overreacting or anything.
Well, he's the boss.
I may need a hand here later on, Birch. The storm's bound to make you-know-who jumpy. You know how they get.
Gotcha. Doc's got me looking after
something's wrong. Hartman had mentioned that the power had been acting up. Maybe that was the reason for the generator and the work light on the balcony. The generator hadn't been activated, and there was no key.
Trapped in this cabin, have been for days, but it's always dark outside. My editor is real.
Hey, Wake, why don't you humor Dr. Hartman and give the writing a shot, huh? Typewriter's in your room.
Old woman's face. She was covered in clinging shadows. There's a hole in her chest where her heart should be. I think I've made a horrible
mistake. You can get to your room by those stairs,
Wake. I don't think I'm any closer to saving Alice. It's been lying to me, using me to get the story it wants, and the story will come true.
Hartman wanted me to write. I knew I couldn't, but I figured I... The white glare of the blank page in front of me hurt my eyes. My hands began to shake uncontrollably.
Everybody, calm down. Put that down. Bert, I need help.
Hey, Wake, you stay here. I'm gonna go see what's up. You just keep doing what you're doing. Be cool, okay?
I didn't know what the chaos was all about, but it could be my only chance of getting out of here.
Where the hell did he get a damn
hammer?
I don't
my
know.
My hammer's up. Here's a friendly poke from me, old little witch.
Oh, afraid of the crazy brothers, are ya? Not so weak now, are we? Well, things are unraveling fast, aren't they?
Sinclair looked bad. That wasn't a love tap. The crazy old fart hit her hard. If she was one of Hartman's goons, she had it coming. I had to get to Hartman's office. He had taken all my manuscript pages. That's where he'd been keeping them.
Come out and face the music, Birch! It's time to pay the piper!
Maybe you could come out and beat our wrinkled adult diapered asses.
Let me out of here! Hartman, do you hear me? I'm gonna sue your crazy quack ass to shreds!
Barry?
Ow! About time!
Barry, man, am I glad to see you.
We need to get to Hartman's office.
It's right next door.
You okay?
Yeah.
These were all the pages I had on me. And more.
Alan, please. You're sliding back into the...
Tell me one more lie and I'll shoot you in the face.
Ah, well, it was worth a shot. Really, Wake, come on. Let's work together on this. You have no idea...
Hartman, shut up! Barry, get out of here. I'll catch up with you. Get a car.
Oh, Al, let's just...
Go!
Wake, listen to me. This is a mistake. Don't you see? Together we can create something absolutely wonderful with your ability and mine.
The dark presence would be on me in a moment. I had to find a way out.
Gate's locked. You're gonna have to go through the hedge maze over there.
Barry, I don't have a light.
Take this, Al. Oh, God! Look at the house, Al! Look out!
Thank you. the channel. We turn it off. We don't want any fighting. It makes peace. You get 2 pills in the morning, and then you'll be nice and calm all day.
Let's get out of here. Can you open this gate?
Maybe.
Barry.
Well, I slammed it shut when the nasty showed up, and the key fits kind of loose in the lock, so,
Barry!
I'll find it! Don't worry about it!
Barry! Barry.
I'm on it!
You're now leaving Bright Falls. Come back soon, sign.
We're going to the Anderson farm.
I knew you were gonna say something like that. You know what? You owe me big time for this. When this is through, if we make it, I don't care what anybody says, I'm done with darkness. You're gonna buy me a tanning bed as a gift, and I'm gonna live in it. You got that right, Al. You're barking mad. You are by far the craziest...
But maybe that's inevitable when you deal with crazy stuff like this. It helps. This is happening, Barry. Alice, they never had Alice. She's trapped in the darkness at the bottom of the lake, but she's not dead.
Al, how can you know that?
I know, Barry. I can...
Al, I...
No, listen. I can bring her back. I can find her. There's something special about this place. The lake, it does something to the works of art created here. It makes them come true. But there's a catch. The dark presence, whatever that thing is, twists it to its own ends. That's why all of this is happening. It's using my manuscript to take over everything.
Al, I believe you.
It happened to Thomas Zane before, it happened to the Andersons.
I believe you. Crazy or not, you're not delusional. Weird shit's going down. That's a fact. I'm on board, man. I'm with you.
The Andersons knew about it, but they were too far gone to tell me with all the drugs they were on. But they wrote it down. There's a message somewhere at their farm, Barry. You just need to find it.
Look out!
I had lost my gun in the crash. Barry was nowhere to be seen.
Barry! Barry!
Oh, man, you're okay! Jeez, it's good to hear your voice! I was trying to get out of the car, but the ground gave way! Man, what a drop! Don't worry, your cutout is fine.
Forget that! Are you okay?
I hit some bushes, didn't get a scratch. There's no way you can climb down, though. It's like a sheer wall. Al! There's something moving down here!
Barry, it's a take-in! Use the flare, Barry!
Ah! Yeah!
Barry, are you all right?
I'm good, Al! I'm great! Guess you never messed with anyone from New York City before, huh? You're gonna have to find your way around to the farm, Al! I'll be waiting!
Barry, just wait for me, okay?
I'm not staying here. It's suicide. I'm going to the farm. I'm gonna go ahead and secure the area. You can catch up. Don't worry about it. I'm on the case.
Now he's Rambo.
This would turn into a disaster if I didn't catch up. crawled over the gate. I needed a light to destroy them to get through. Sense the movement in the woods ahead. Facing the enemy without a weapon was dangerous, but I had no choice. Driving away from the farm, headed in the same general direction as I was. For all I knew, it was Barry, caught in the consequences of leaping before looking. Was heading for the cabin up ahead. It wasn't far. If it was Barry, I would see the damage soon.
To the right time and place. I'm trying to show you how the story goes.
I had seen glimpses of the light before. I had seen it in my dream. It was a strange spaceman or a diver in a suit. He was the one who'd been placing the pages on my path. Someone had left a gun behind. Now I had a fighting chance of reaching the farm. I could see the car, but there was no sight of the driver.
Hello? Anybody here?
Ah!
Barry!
Ah! Ah! No! Danny, you're not! Ah! Please! Ah! What are you? What are you? Ah! No! Don't! I'm sorry! Ah! Ah!
I know you. You were in jail the other day.
I went to the farm again for the moonshine, you know? It makes you see. They're not gonna miss it. They're in the loony bin. My buddy, Danny, I lost him. Something's gone wrong with him. It's not him. Like a real bad follow-up to a real good...
I've run through every possible course in my head. If I continue like the Dark Presence wants me to, the story I'm writing won't save Alice. It's a horror story, and it's going to kill her, and me, and everybody in this town. No one will survive. Darkness will consume everything. This is what it's wanted all along. It will be free, unstoppable. It used Alice to get to me, dangled her in front of me to keep me going. It was never going to release her. I'm going to change this. I'll escape. I've written myself into the story. I'm now the protagonist. This feels like a terrible risk, but it's the only way to save Alice. I'll be bound by the events of the story just as much as anyone else who's been woven into it. The story must stay true for this to work. There have to be victims along the way. Near escapes, cliffhangers. In a horror story, it can't be certain that the hero will succeed or even survive. He almost has to die. I'll write my own escape into the story next. I need help. Zane's going to be the one who will help me. I'll make it happen.
Still a good distance away. I'd need a car to get there fast. If Barry wasn't up here, he was probably in trouble down at the farm. For a moment, I felt bad for doubting him. After all, I'd made it this far myself. But Barry was Barry. I'd known the brothers used to be some kind of rock stars, but it hadn't really sunk in until I saw the stage.
Al! Run! Incoming! There's too many of them!
God damn!
I'm so glad you decided to go it alone, Mr. Bronson.
Shut up and shoot!
Al! We have to fight them all! I can set up one of the fireworks from here and help you out! Hey, Al! Did you notice there's a lot of ammo and stuff around? This place is stopped! Al, hold on! I'll try to get the stage lights on!
Falls, rock and roll capital of America.
Hey, Al! This way to the farm!
Thank you.
see, bestseller. No reason to worry. Your cutout's good as new, right where I left it. I'll come back for it once we have the place secured.
I think Alan Wake here has something to say. What's that, Al?
Ooh, I'm Alan Wake. I'm always right about everything. And if I don't get my way, I'll sulk all day long. I'm always intense and moody. It makes me very attractive and mysterious. Right now, I'm just standing here because I need my best friend, Barry, to carry me. But that's okay. I can just take him for granted.
I think I see what you did there.
Yeah, it was pretty good.
You want me to do my imitation of Barry Wheeler? No? Thought so. The Viking boat looked imposing, almost like a battering ram.
Through here, Al!
Wow! Those geezers had quite a production going on. Ooh, you know what, Al? If we make it through this alive, I'm gonna start representing them. Yep, sell this stuff online, maybe get a reality show going, release a new single.
Good luck with that, pal.
Hey, you find us a way out of here, okay? I'm gonna take a closer look at this stuff.
The door was barred from the other side. I'd have to find another way.
Be careful, Al!
Open, okay?
As you regular listeners know, I tend to work through the night, but I'm not the only one. Deputies Mulligan and Thornton are taking a couple of moments off their busy schedule to join me here in the studio. Boys, how busy are you now? Deerfest is almost here, isn't it? I bet that keeps you in business.
Pretty busy, yeah.
Actually, Pat, we've been real busy with a lot of stuff.
None of which concerns...
I could see the building that had to be the Andersons' home on the other side of the field. It wasn't far now. I wasn't worried about trusting the ramblings of two burned-out geriatric wrecks. They had the goods.
You out there, buddy?
I had to find a key to get Barry out.
Yeah, it's me. Hang on. I'll try to find a key to get the door open.
the holdup. Come on, this place is all dusty. You know I got my allergies.
Hey, let's go, man. I think we're gonna have to work together to open this gate, Al. Looks pretty heavy. Ah! Hey, I think that's the farm on the other side of the field. We're almost there. This farm is a crazy place for crazy people.
We should feel right at home then.
Come on, one more gig. Let's do this thing. The lights are out. I guess we better check the fuse box. You know, this place looks kind of lived in. I thought the Andersons were in the booby hatch.
Yeah, I don't think they keep too close an eye on them at the clinic. They seem to slip away a lot so they can get wasted.
Can you hear that, Al? Music?
Of course. We need to find where it's coming from. That's the message the Andersons talked about. That's the whole reason we're here.
Lady of the Light? Oh, that's gotta be... What's her face? The crazy lamp lady from the town.
Cynthia Weaver.
Right. Must be.
Okay?
We need to find Cynthia Weaver. We'll stay here for the night and head back to town as soon as it gets light.
Hey, Al. Lots of hours before dawn. Might as well get some rest. And by rest, I mean drunk.
Come on, Barry. This is... Yeah, what the hell?
I'm gonna stick by you, no matter what, ever, Al.
Sure, like a brother.
I'm a writer, goddammit.
Correct.
If I just wanted to, I could write 10 books a year. And they'd be the best books that year.
No, you couldn't.
That's right, I couldn't. But I could, because I'm a writer.
What? What do they put in this stuff? I feel like my brain is coming out of my nose. I'm gonna get the recipe off those coots and be a booze millionaire.
I just miss her, Barry. I just want her here with me.
I know, Al. I know. It's gonna be okay. We're gonna make it okay.
Crazy drunken dream. And yet, it was more than that. It was the truth. A suppressed memory unearthed by the Andersons' moonshine. I was there, an out-of-body observer. This was the night Alice and I had arrived at Bright Falls, the night Alice had disappeared. I had a chance to find
Alice,
out what had happened.
Alice.
I remembered being surprised to see the cabin dark. Alice would have never turned the lights off. I remembered thinking, I caught a glimpse of her form underwater, sinking into the darkness. Diving after her was the last vague memory I had of that night. After that, the next thing I could remember was waking up behind the wheel of the crash car and finding the first pages of the manuscript. Beyond this lost memory, there was nothing. I had to follow the footsteps of my past self to find out what had happened that night. I couldn't find her in all that blackness. I must have thought she drowned.
Alice!
Jagger had Alice, and so she had me.
Alice!
I'd been easy prey.
Look at the cabin. Is there someone in the window?
Alice?
Maybe she didn't drown after all. Maybe she's inside.
Alice!
Yes.
The dark presence had touched me. She had dug her nails into my brain and used me. Made me her puppet.
She must be here somewhere. Maybe upstairs in the study.
Alice!
Yes, that's where she is. You can apologize.
Alice!
You laugh at the whole thing together and put it behind you. She's not here. You were foolish to think so. No, she's dead. She drowned.
No, no, no!
It's your fault your wife is dead. You are guilty. All she wanted was to help you, right? You killed her.
Ah!
Oh, hush. There's still hope. Cauldron Lake is a special place. Here, you have the power to change things. She wanted you to write. I will tell you what to do. You can write her back. The story will come true, and all will be well again.
She had Alice, and the manuscript was the ransom for her.
Yes, I'll write. I'll fix it. I'll bring her back.
In the dark, I'd written for days, a week, almost a complete manuscript of a novel entitled Departure. Jagger had been my editor, whispering in my ear, making sure that the unfolding story would make her more and more powerful. I thought I was saving Alice. Even with the cobweb she put in my head, some part of me had been aware enough to write my escape into the story, to bring a light into the cabin to release me before I could finish. To interrupt the horror story before the ending, where darkness consumed everything and everyone. Zane was weak and far away, but I had written him into the story, and his light had been enough to set me free.
It isn't here now. I'm here because it was written. I brought the light to set you free. You must hurry. It will know I'm here. It will be back soon. It stole the skin of my armor a long time ago. She looks so old.
I had woken up, confused and groggy, my mind consumed by darkness and fear. All I could do was to escape. Taken its toll. I was barely conscious and fading fast. It had to have cost Zane terribly, thrown him even deeper into whatever dark place he now haunted. But he had managed to weaken the dark presence. kept me safe that night.
I wrote it. It's my fault.
That's right, James Joyce. It's your fault, and you're gonna pay for it.
There's an old tarot with mystery of Tom the Poet and his muse, and a magic lake which gave a light to the words the poet used. Now the muse, she was his happiness, and he rhymed about her grace and told the stories of treasures deep beneath the blackened waves. Till in the stillness of one dawn, still in its misty crown, she went down to the lake, and in the waves she'd drown. And now to see your love set free, you will need the witch's cabin key. Find the lady.